politics, megawatt, a better place. We have 40 days to make a world a better place. We are smart at what we do to make a world a better place. We are smart at what we do to make a world a better place. By the help of God, to make a world a better place.
Lesson today. We are looking at the Galilean ministry, rejection of Jesus at Nazareth. Remember, in our previous lesson, we looked at the areas in which a Christian can be tempted. And we looked again at the lesson a Christian learned from the temptations of Jesus. The lessons that a Christian learned from the temptation. Now, today I want us to go to the rejection of Jesus at Nazareth. Now, this is found in the book of Luke, chapter 4, verse 14 to 30, and in the book of Isaiah, chapter 61, verse 1 to 3. So today we'll read the Bible. Remember, I told you that the form to work is purely based on the St. Luke's Gospel, and we are looking at the Good News Bible, or the Revised Standard Version used for setting of exams. So I want us to go to the book of Luke. Want us to go to the book of Luke, chapter 4, the book of Luke, chapter 4, verses 14 to 30. We'll not read to 30, you'll read at your own time to verse 30. So I want us to just read there and see what it says about the rejection of Jesus. Remember, Jesus just began his work in Galilee. Now, Luke chapter 14, verse 4. Luke chapter 4, verse 14 to 30. Verse 14, the Bible says, "Then Jesus returned to Galilee, and the power of the Holy Spirit was with him. The news about him spread throughout all the territory. He taught in the synagogues and was praised by everyone." Rejection, chapter 16, verse 16. Then Jesus went to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, and on a Sabbath he went as usual to the synagogue. He stood up to read the scriptures and was handed the book of the prophet Isaiah. He unrolled the scroll and found the place where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has chosen me to bring good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim liberty to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to set free the oppressed, to announce that the time has come when the Lord will save the people." This is just part of what Jesus read from the scroll about his rejection. And now, Jesus went to the synagogue. He was given a scroll to read. And where he read the scroll, he just read about himself. He just read a place where it was written about himself. The same thing has been written in the book of Isaiah, chapter 61, verses. Isaiah, chapter 61, the book of Isaiah, chapter 61, verses 1 to 3. Let's go there. 61, "The sovereign Lord has filled me with his spirit. He has chosen me and sent me to bring good news to the poor, to heal the brokenhearted, to announce release of the captives and freedom to those in prison. He has sent me to proclaim that the time has come when the Lord will save his people and defeat their enemies." Now, this is the same thing that Jesus read, that the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Now, he was just referring to himself. From these incidents, after he had read these scriptures, he gave back the scroll to the teachers of the law. And thereafter, the people, after hearing what he had read, They wanted to kill him. They wanted to take him and throw him down over a cliff. And Jesus tried to manage and move out of them. And now, some of the reasons why these people were rejecting him. Remember, that is a rejection. He had just prayed and people want to kill him. So some of the reasons for his rejection. Reason number one, he was known by people as being the son of Joseph and Mary. And now here he's telling people that the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He has sent me to proclaim the good news to the poor. People did not believe him. Why? He was just a son of Mary and Joseph. Reasons for rejection. Reasons for rejection. One, he was the son of Joseph. Jesus was the son of Joseph. That was the reason number one. Was the son of Joseph and Mary. And people could not believe that he could be a Messiah. Another thing, he did not fit in the shoe of being a leader. He did not fit in the shoes of being a political leader. He did not qualify to be a political leader. Remember, these people are waiting for a leader. They are waiting for the Savior. And according to them, they believe that the Savior will come in form of a political leader who will help them overcome their enemies in wars and in battle. Now, it is contrary that Jesus is coming to them by the power of the Holy Spirit. And now they did not believe in him. Now they had to do what? They had to reject him. Another thing, he did not follow the law of Moses. He did not follow laws of Moses. Jesus did not follow the laws of Moses. The laws of fasting, praying, going without food for a long time. Jesus did not follow such laws. Another thing, he associated with the sinners. He associated with sinners. Jesus here is associating with the sinners, and according to them, these people believe that a Messiah will be somebody who is very pure, somebody who they are expecting to sit on the throne, their physical throne. They did not understand the spiritual throne about this person. So these are some of the reasons why Jesus might have been rejected with these people. Why these people want to throw Jesus down the cliff because he has read the scripture that he was a son of Mary and Joseph. He did not qualify. He was just an ordinary person. They are seeing him walking here and there, going through the suffering people are going through. Now, they did not believe that he can be a leader. Another thing is that he is associating with a sinner. He's associating with a sinner. So that was, these are some of the reasons for his rejection. Continue reading the St. Luke's Gospel, Luke chapter 1 to chapter 24. See you in the next lesson. Have a nice time. Thank you.